Hello ROS developers and welcome to a new video about how to develop with ROS. If you want to learn anything about ROS, this is your channel. We have ROS navigation, ROS with drones and ROS for autonomous cars. Everything ROS is here. Learn ROS step by step and push your ROS learning with just a 10 minutes video. Hi, I am Ricardo, and today we are going to answer this question about why the laser scans are received but not shown on Rviz. And the answer will surprise you, as it is said in the clickbait videos. But before anything else, remember to visit the Robot Ignite Academy, our online academy where you will find practical online ROS courses using simulated robots. No installation required, and you will find the link to the academy on the video description. Okay, so now let's start with the question of this guy that says that he has created a package, a very simple package for beginners, and he is publishing a fake laser and he would like to display it on Rviz. But however, he's finding that the laser messages are being received in Rviz, but they are not shown on Rviz. So let's go and let's try to figure out what's happening. Okay, first, let's create a project on the RDS. So for that, we are going to use the RDS, the ROS Development Studio, and you can get a free account just by visiting this rds.deconstructsim.com, and just with this free account you can do exactly the same things I'm doing here. So let's create a new project. Let's call it, for example, fake laser visualization. Okay, and for code from Git. Okay, from which Git? This Git here. Copy and let's paste it here. Okay, created. And now let's open the project. So now it's a project, it's an empty project, so it's going to contain nothing. And then what we are going to do is to clone this repo and see what's happening on that code. So let's go open a shell, a new shell, and let's copy it. So let's go. For that, we need to go to the catkin workspace /source. Why? Because we are doing ROS code. It's not simulation code, it's ROS code. So here we are going to do the clone. Let me show you, this is an empty directory, it contains nothing because it's an empty project. So let's clone this guy repo, and there it is, there we have. So, yeah, there it is, the fake laser scan. And if we open here, let me open with the, yeah, that's previous work that I was doing, no problem, here, and then here we have the fake scan code. So the first thing that I notice here is that your package is called beginner's tutorial, but your directory is called fake laser scan. Okay, so this is not an error, but it's not a good practice because you get confused. When you are looking here, then you see where is this? Where is this fake beginner's tutorials? Because you only see this, this directory. That's not a good idea. In order to go faster and as a standard. But if we go to the CMake list, we can see that that is the beginner's tutorial. Let me increase the size of this, this size. Yeah, so you can see better. Great, so it's a beginner's tutorial. It's just the directory that is called fake laser scan. Okay, so if we check the code is here for the laser scan, and it is publishing a fake laser, as you can see here, in a frame ID that is called fake laser frame, and then it's publishing just a value of intensity, range, that is, where is ranges here, and these ranges is generated here at the same distance, at 5 meters, 5 meters. It's the max, the distance that those ranges. So we should see kind of semicircle for all the angles from minus pi to pi. He's publishing this. Okay, so the code I have reviewed and is correct, and it's publishing in a topic that is called the fake scan. Fake scan. Okay, so far so good. So what do we have to do now is to compile. So let's go here and then calc make. And then once it is compiled, we are going to launch it. And let me put it there so we can see here. For launching, we have here a launch file. That is the one. And let's put it signal.xml. And it's just launching this code. It's just launching the fake scan. That is the binary that has been built here. Okay, so let's launch it then. It's already compiled, so let's launch it. ROS launch. And the package name is beginner tutorials. Then fake laser scan.launch. Okay, so there it is. And it is there publishing. Let's open a new shell in order to launch the Rviz. And for this, also we can check if we do a ROS topic list that it's there, the topic, so it's there. So, and even we can do a ROS topic echo minus N1, only one, okay, of the fake scan. And we can see that it's publishing great. So it looks like it's working. Yeah, so let's have a look in Rviz what is happening. So launch Rviz, and then in order to see the Rviz, we need to open a new tool that is called a graphical tool. This will allow us to see all the windows that are executed in the ROS Development Studio, I mean system, desktop system applications like Rviz, for example. So double click to center this, and I'm going to remove here. We cannot see anything here. And also we see here a problem global. Okay, fix it. No TF data. Okay, so first thing, let's add the laser. Okay, so this is the basic. Okay, let's see the laser scan. And here it is, and let's configure here the topic. The topic should be the fake scan that we already know. Yes, so there it is. And we see nothing, so the only thing that we can see is the topic, it's okay. Status, it's okay. So everything looks like it's okay, but we see nothing. And here we have the first problem, frame. Okay, so fake laser frame to map doesn't exist. Yes, because the fixed frame is not showing, is the map, and we don't have any transform for map. So here in the question, it's the guy, he decided to publish a static transform between the frame of the laser and the map. Okay, so that's possible in order to solve this question, but actually you don't need it because you only need to change here the frame, and it doesn't allow us because nobody's publishing that, but so it's not showing as an option, but we can just type here, for example, the name of the frame that is the fake laser frame. So let's do it. Okay, so let's write it there. It's called fake laser frame. There it is. And then there is no problem here. So it's by changing the fixed frame manually. So we see nothing, and we see here that the messages are being received. And that's also indicated here. So he's receiving the message, but he cannot see. So now, what about the answer to the question that will surprise you? Okay, so let's do something here. Let's increase the size of the points, of the dots that are representing the laser. And there it is. So basically, it was as simple as just changing the size of the dot of the fake laser. There it is, and you have it. Yes. Didn't it surprise you, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, so another thing, just to finish this question, it's about this transform. So why is publishing this transform? Okay, this is possible. You can publish any transform if you want, and any transform that you want. So from fake laser, and then select the map here, the map dot. So we can do it. So and see that it's exactly the same thing, but you actually don't need it. So let's open a new shell and copy this transform that he is publishing, and let's put it here. So now this transform is being published, and if we come here, we can see that we can select between those two, because now TF has some data. Also, the global status error has disappeared. So you can select the map as a frame, and also nothing happens. So the same data is being published, of course. And now it's represented from the map, but the map is at the same coordinates as the fake laser frame. So nothing changes. No. I hope that you understand this different, okay? So this is the information of the laser represented on the map frame, and this is the laser information represented from the fake laser frame. Yeah, that's exactly the same. Yes. Okay, so that's it for today. So I hope that you understood. This was a nice exercise in order to learn and to start learning about ROS and how does it work all the parts together. That's why we decided to do it. And well, if in the description, if you need to learn more, so you, in the description of the video, you will find a complete course about ROS basics, and either in Python or C++, as well as all the resources that I have mentioned here in the video. And if you like the video, then please give us a thumbs up and remember to subscribe to our channel and press the bell for receiving a new video every day. We publish a new video every day. So, and either you like it or not, please share your thoughts and questions in the comments area of the video. Hasta la vista,